family in Jesus. I hope you are blessed this morning. I hope you had a good night's rest. We're getting to the Word of God again this morning. Before we do that, I'd just like to share a testimony with you, a personal testimony about something that happened 10 years ago. If you want to follow in the Word of God this morning, we're reading out of 1 Peter chapter 1. So you can go there so long while I start with a testimony. So the majority of you have heard the testimony about when the boys were born, my twin boys, and Caleb was basically born without a heartbeat. He didn't have a pulse. His lungs weren't developed. And they took him out of the theater into the ICU. And for 3 hours, I sat outside praying and interceding for my boy, for my son. I had a lot of questions that I shared with my God, my Creator, because He knows us. He knows there's nothing that we can hide from the Lord. And so the things that I were questioning and thinking, I was sharing with the Lord and not with people, because sometimes we share our deep thoughts and questions with people, and all we get back is opinions. We don't get the Word of God back. So I was sitting there sharing this with the Lord, and yes, I will admit I'm still human. I was very saddened by what was happening. I felt there was sorrow in me. And while I was sitting outside the ICU waiting for the doctors to give me some information about my boy, a man came and sat next to me that I did not know at all. He was waiting for someone that was coming out of ICU as well. And he started speaking to me. So he looked at me and he said to me, "Wow, you look a bit down and a bit depressed, and are you okay?" So I said to him, "I'm fine, thank you." And I told him the story about the boys that were born and what happened to Caleb and whatever. And then I ended the testimony to him. I ended and I said, "But I'm trusting in the Lord that He will help." And as I said that, this man snickered. And he said, "Oof, the Lord." So I turned to him and I said, "I'm sorry, I don't understand. What did I say wrong now? Did I say something wrong?" So he said, no, you just said, you know, you trust in the Lord, that the Lord will help you." So I said to him, "Yes, what's wrong with that?" So he said to me, "Do you really believe there is such a thing as a God?" So he said, "Because I don't, I'm an atheist. I don't believe there is a God." And then without me answering, this man got into a very personal confrontation with me. And he started telling me how, to him, Christians, all Christians that he knows are fools, and churches are, to him, it's they like circuses, and if you want a good show and you want a good laugh, just go and sit in a church every Sunday and you see what's happening there. And because he says those same people leave the churches and they go into the world, he says, and the majority of the Christians that he knows, there's no difference between them and the atheist friends that he has. He says they live exactly the same life, they do exactly the same things. He says so many Christians that he knows that owns things that are against the Word of God, that cause people to sin and go into sin. He says you Christians are a bunch of clowns, basically, he said, and it's a good show. And I got really agitated by this man, because it started getting personal, because to me, when someone speaks against Christianity, they speak against the people that I love and the people that the Lord have sent me to lead and to guide and to teach. And when people speak against Christianity, they also speak against my Savior, my King, because I carry His name, and I must represent the name of Jesus Christ, and I must represent Christians and Christianity. So I said to him, "Look, I really don't care what you believe in, but please don't come and disrespect what we believe in, because I didn't do it towards you." And then this man went on and on and on, and he said to me, "Well, if you are such a big Christian," and it was a challenge, but just at the wrong time. He said to me, well, if you are a Christian and you believe in God, we're in a hospital, so stand up and go and heal all these people. So I said to him, first of all, I only do what God leads me to do, not what an atheist challenges me to do. And second of all, the Bible teaches us that the Holy Spirit gives us gifts as He wants. I didn't get the gift of healing. And it's not me that heals, it's God. So he says, yeah, you see that you Christians always have all these excuses and all these excuses. So he said to me, prove to me that God exists. Prove to me. So I said to him, okay, if you're a man, if you're a true man, then you will take the challenge that you just gave me now. So I said, just wait here, I'm coming. So I stood up and I walked outside to my car. And at that stage, we were in the ministry. We were ministering in a church. And we always have Bibles with us that we distribute to people. So I went and I opened the boot of the car and I took out a Bible, brand new Bible. And I walked back in to the hospital. And I walked up to that atheist, and he was still sitting there snickering. And I handed him the Bible. I actually pushed it into his hands. And as he took it, I said to him, you read through that Bible, and you prove to me God does not exist. And it was amazing to me that if I had fought him with my own words, it would have become an ugly, disgusting thing. And the Bible teaches us not to argue about the Word of God. But if we come and we approach this world with the pure Word of God, not our opinions, not our feelings and not our minds, but the pure and holy Word of God, if we approach the world with that, we will in every single time conquer the world, every time. Because when I said that to him, when I said to him, you read through this Bible and you prove to me God does not exist by what you have read there. He did not say a word, but put the Bible down, he stood up and he walked away. I want to share a scripture this morning that relates to that in the Word of God. In 1 Peter chapter 1, I'm going to read from verse 24. The Bible says, all people are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, verse 25, but the word of the Lord endures forever. And this is the word that was preached to you. So yeah, the Bible is clear that the word of God endures forever. They have been trying, this world and Satan has been trying to stop the movement of Jesus Christ on this earth for 2,000 years now already. They have been trying to suppress us, and they've taken the Lord out of businesses. They've taken the Lord out of schools. They've taken the Lord out of society. They've taken the name of Jesus out of everything that they could have taken him out. But they still cannot silence the truth of Jesus Christ. They cannot silence his voice. They can't. Because in us, that is the temples of the Holy Spirit, and they choose to live the Holy Word of God, and they choose to be obedient to the Holy Spirit, they cannot keep us quiet. They can't. So I want to encourage everyone this morning that if this has happened to you, if you have been challenged in such a disgusting way and such a way that makes you feel small, just, brother and sister in Christ, stand up. Stand up today, knowing that you don't have to be ashamed of anything. The Bible teaches us, Paul teaches us, that I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, because in that is my salvation. It's my power, it's my strength, it's my wisdom and my knowledge and my insight. It's my past, my present, and my future. The gospel of Jesus Christ is my everything. It's my everything. I cannot imagine a life without the gospel of Jesus. I cannot imagine it. I can't. This world can take away absolutely everything else that I am looking after for the Lord. Because I don't own anything either. I am a steward of the things that the Lord has given me. The money that I receive every month is not mine. It's the Lord's. He's giving it to me to see how I work with His things. The people that I serve in my church as the shepherd, they don't belong to me. They belong to the Lord. The Lord has given them to me to see how I teach them. Do I teach them the truth? Do I teach them the pure word of God, or do I add my own opinion and my own flesh? So I know, standing here this morning, and I want to encourage you, brother and sister in Christ, if this has happened to you, don't feel ashamed. We do not have to be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus. We must be proud. When Jesus said in the Beatitudes that blessed are you when you are persecuted because of my name, then yes, brother and sister in Christ, we are blessed. We are blessed every time somebody comes against us because we are standing firm on the holy word of Jesus Christ. Don't be ashamed. Don't. Be blessed in Jesus' name, knowing that you are doing something that your Father in heaven is proud of. And the angels rejoice every time that we stand up for the gospel of Jesus. So today I want to encourage you. Stand up, brother and sister. Don't feel down and don't feel depressed if this has happened to you. I know this even happens in our families, our blood families, where brothers and sisters draw up against you, mothers and fathers and aunts and uncles and granddads and grandmoms, that where they come against us because we choose only to live on the word of God. Don't let go of that because we want to please people. Please keep in mind, brother and sister in Jesus, it is not those people that can get you and me into heaven. Jesus did not say to us we must walk around pleasing people. He did say to us we must serve them. But He didn't say we must please them. We are here to please God, to please Jesus, to please our Father in heaven, to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. And through that, the gospel of Jesus Christ will be our salvation and our strength. It will be our encouragement, our joy, our peace, our patience, our long-suffering. The Word of God teaches us all that. So as we go into prayer now, pray the Holy Spirit will encourage you through this that we have read this morning. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of your Son Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you for your word and the beautiful truth of your word. We thank you, Father God, that your word endures forever. It lasts forever, Lord. The foundations of this earth was created by your word. And Lord, this earth will one day be destroyed and finished by your word. It is by your word, Lord, that we were created, that we were given a plan and a purpose. It is by your word that one day revival will come to our town in Eltham. It is by your word, Lord Jesus, that you have ordained every ministry in this church of ours. It is by your word, Lord Jesus, that you have anointed every leader in this church of ours. It is by your word, Lord Jesus, that you have called every single person into this storehouse, Lord Jesus, to be fed by your word, to be taught by us as the leaders, Lord Jesus, and to build your kingdom. Your word, Lord, will last forever. And your word teaches us in the book of Revelations, Lord Jesus, that when everything is done, you, Lord Jesus, will be our temple in the New Jerusalem in heaven, and the word of God will be ministered to us for eternity. We thank you for that, Father God. Lord, I pray that you will continue to bless your people, Lord. I pray that as this week unfolds and comes to an end, Lord Jesus, into the weekend, that you will bless them exceedingly abundantly. I thank you, Father God, that you have kept your hand of protection and provision over all of us, Lord Jesus. I thank you that you have kept us together. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that through a small little thing like a video camera, Lord, You have kept us in touch with each other, being able to feed your people with the word of God every single day. We bring you the glory for that, Lord Jesus. We thank you. Lord, we pray. We ask all of this in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Thank you, family in Jesus. I can't say it enough. While we have time, get into the Word more and more every single day. Seek Jesus. Study His Word. Learn the Word of God. Hide it in your heart. Let it envelop your mind. Let it become your everything. Let the Word of God become you. So that when we are able to get out into the world again, that this world can immediately see a drastic change in us, each one of us, that the world can see Jesus in us without us even speaking. I pray you all have a blessed day, and thank you again for this time that you are affording us. I hope this is still a blessing unto you. I hope this is still food unto your soul every single morning. Until we meet again tomorrow, be blessed in Jesus' name.